Was man created by God, or did they evolve from apes? It is actually not well understood how the present humans, that is, we Homo sapiens, evolved. In the previous video, the moon was a spacecraft that was boarded by an advanced civilization of intelligent life, and that life form created the human race. I told the story up to that point. In this issue, I would like to continue and explain how intelligent life raised humans. If you are interested in the last one, please watch that video as well. Have you ever heard of the missing link? The missing link is the non-continuous part of the evolutionary process of an organism. For some reason, no fossils have been found in that area. And for some reason, this missing link exists in humanity as well. Primates, the direct ancestors of humans, began to walk on two legs. It is said to be 6 to 5 million years old. Its primates evolved into apes about 4 to 3 million years ago. Have you ever heard of Australopithecus? Australopithecus was not found in Australia. It means southern monkey. As the name suggests, it was discovered in Africa, far south of Europe. Later, about 2 million years ago, ape men called Homo habilis appeared. This ape man was so advanced that he could use stone tools. Now, about 1.8 million years ago, proto-humans, more evolved than apes, appeared. One famous fossil was found on the Indonesian island of Java, Pithecanthropus, called the Javan proto-human. There are synanthropes and other species, such as the Peking proto-humans, found in Beijing. These proto-humans apparently lived in caves, wore furs, and used fire. In addition, as time progresses, the old humans now emerge. The Neanderthals, who were primarily in Europe, and the Denisovans, who were in Asia, are known. They were hunters. It is believed that they also provided flowers to the Zeros. Later, about 200,000 years ago, a new species appeared. It is Homo sapiens, also known as the present humans. The most famous new human species is the Cro-Magnon, discovered in France. Many of you may have seen the murals written on the caves. There is nothing strange about the story so far. What follows, however, is the missing link. In fact, these Cro-Magnon people are not connected to us, the present humans. They become extinct without leaving any descendants. In other words, the human genealogy ceases here. And the old humans, Neanderthals and Denisovans, are a completely different species from us. These old humans also became extinct long ago. So, from which ancestor did we, the present humans, evolve? Or did they appear out of the blue? Well, here are my thoughts. There is some speculation involved. Just think of it as your usual sci-fi movie and listen. The answer apparently seems to lie with aliens. Intelligent life aboard a lunar spacecraft was responsible for the birth of the present human race. Can we not assume that they are involved? Originally, this intelligent life form, let's call them aliens for simplicity. They tried to exterminate the dinosaurs and create a creature with an intelligence more like their own, and they evolved the monkeys step by step. Apes evolved as expected by the aliens. They use stone tools and fire, live in caves, wear furs, and mourn the dead. However, for the aliens, something important must have been missing, so they manipulated the human genes of the time. And so we, the present humans, Homo sapiens, were born. This is how we were born. Later, they learned many things from the aliens and built their civilization. For humans at that time, aliens were there to teach and guide them. Yes, mankind considered aliens to be gods. But what evidence is there that aliens are gods? Of course, we cannot make assumptions about God lightly. But it seems to me that aliens and God have certain things in common. That is where both live in heaven. The Christian Lord's Prayer begins with these words: Our Father who art in heaven. Japan's Kojiki, Record of Ancient Matters, also states that Takaminpara, where the gods resided, was above the heavens. Where is it? Yes, the moon. More precisely, it was based on a spaceship in the shape of the moon. They traveled between the moon and Earth in a space shuttle-like vehicle. How do you know it is a space shuttle? In fact, it is because it has been excavated from ancient ruins. It is on display at the Museum of Gold in Bogota, the capital of Colombia. The size of the work is about 5 centimeters wide and 1 centimeter high. It has a very strange shape. No matter how you look at it, it looks like a space shuttle. The scholar who appraised this was too curious. Bell helicopter designer Arthur Young was asked to verify. The result was well within the bounds of aerodynamics. In other words, it was a form that could fly. So why in the world would an object in the shape of a space shuttle be found in South America? There is one big clue. In fact, the place called Sinú, Colombia, where this workmanship was excavated, it is not far from where the Nazca paintings are located. Although the Nazca paintings are known for their drawings of animals and plants, such as monkeys and hummingbirds, in fact, there are numerous straight lines that resemble runways. It is quite possible that an alien space shuttle took off and landed here. These facts suggest the fact that humans at that time frequently communicated with aliens coming from the sky. This is one of the evidences that humans learned a lot from aliens and built civilization. Isn't it good to think about it? So, are we humans living up to their expectations? I am not sure about that, but the story has been passed down that humanity has been reset once. It is the legend of the Great Flood that remains in many places. The story of Noah's Ark in the Bible is well known. Similar stories are told in China, South America, and many other places. Most of these tell the story of God, angered by mankind's unceasing struggle and corruption, destroying it with a flood. In fact, this flood has been documented. Sumerians, who founded the Mesopotamian civilization as the flood myth, they leave their writing on clay tablets. The story was inscribed around the 17th century BC. In addition, excavations have been conducted on the flood myth. And this flood occurred around 2900 BC to 2750 BC. This has been proven to be the case. The story is inscribed in cuneiform script on clay tablets as the Sumerian flood myth, and it has been dated to the 17th century BC. The story is also dated to the 17th century BC. The story is also inscribed on clay tablets in cuneiform script as the Sumerian flood myth. So, was there only one reset? According to the myth, the flood was so damaging that God declared it would never happen again. Therefore, it is safe to assume that no major floods have occurred since then. Instead, it seems that God, or aliens, have reset humanity several times in other ways. Here is one of them. It is the Tower of Babel. The Tower of Babel will be about the descendants of Noah who survived the flood. Noah's sons began to live in different parts of the world, though. Using new technology, they begin building towers that reach to the heavens. The new technology, according to the book, replaced the previous stone and plaster. It seems to have been a construction technique using bricks and asphalt. I don't know if that is enough to build a tower that reaches to the heavens. But the important point here is that the construction of the tower was done by mankind alone, without the help of God. Some scholars believe that this is a revenge or rebellion against the flood caused by aliens. What did aliens think when they saw this? According to the Bible, God did not destroy the Tower of Babel. It is believed that they did not use less destructive methods, as they declared after the flood. Instead, to the human race, which had previously spoken the same language, we tried to make them each speak a different language. As a result, people lost their language. It is written that each returned to the land of their birth. What does this represent? It seems safe to say that the aliens sensed that their role in raising the human race was over. I think the same language that everyone was speaking was the same language that we could speak with aliens. It may be what we now call telepathy. In any case, humanity is deprived of means of communication such as telepathy. From then on, we were forced to take our own path of life. So let's wrap things up once and for all here. Humans evolved from apes and were genetically engineered by aliens in the final stages. It has developed to the point where it is capable of building a civilization. After that, they were taught many things and developed their civilization. However, with wisdom, mankind took the path of depravity and was reset by the flood. Later, once prosperous again, humans began to do things without the help of aliens. Seeing this, the aliens thought that the educational stage of the human race was over. deprived them of their telepathic abilities, which had been their means of communication with humanity, and that humanity would begin to move forward on its own. So where have the aliens gone? They got on a spaceship and went somewhere else. What? The moon is over there, isn't it? You may be thinking, what? There were several spacecraft on the moon. Even Columbus had a fleet of 3 ships when he crossed the Atlantic. However, there is one spaceship left. This means that perhaps they will return to Earth again. The wars that never seem to stop, the environmental destruction, the widening gap between the rich and the poor. Unfortunately, we humans do not seem to be at the level they expect us to be. Will they see this current situation and think about resetting humanity once again? What can we, who live in the present, do? Once again, all people of the Earth will need to think deeply and act accordingly. See you again in the next video. Thank you for watching to the end.